question on Islam?
Yeah, go on. You don't need to call me sir.
I don't go to the botanic gardens with you, or I don't go to the museum with you, so... What is your top five reasons I should become a Muslim?
Okay, look, top five reasons. Okay. Number one, pick up the Quran in any country, in a Muslim place of worship, masjid, or in a public library. The Quran is one and the same. Okay? Pick up the Bible. There's a Orthodox Bible with 81 books. Bible is a Greek word, it means book. So there's a, pick up the Orthodox Bible, it has 81 books in the Orthodox Christian Bible. Pick up the Catholic Christian Bible, that has 73 books in the Catholic Bible. Pick up your Bible, you are Protestant, in your Bible you have 66 books. So as Christians, you don't even have one book, but you got three different books, so there's confusion.
Okay, let me respond to that.
Yeah, another.
So thing. I did ask you five reasons.
Yeah, but let me give you the other reason.
I know. So it's gonna be too long. Okay. Can I just respond to your first reasoning?
Okay, go
and
on.
Then I'll give you a chance to give me your second reason. Is that all right?
Okay, go on.
Okay. So give me 1 second.
Excuse me. Is that camera on?
I don't know.
Okay, can I move to somewhere else because the sun is coming straight in my eyes? Yes? If you don't mind.
Where do you want to move?
The sun, yeah, look, the sun is coming straight in my eyes. So I'm going to move somewhere and you can come. Because now it's very busy, most areas have been taken. Okay, let's see. Hold on, I'll just check, yeah? I'll check. Yeah, Jazakallah, brother. Thank you. Yes.
So,
sorry, can you move back a bit? Yeah. Move back a bit.
I think
okay,
that you are being fussy now, okay?
You
are being fussy now. I ask you to give me 5 reasons why I should become a Muslim.
Yeah,
your first reason was because if I go to the masjid today, whichever masjid it is, you've got one perfect Quran, it's the same, okay? So let me just debunk that and then also I will respond to your question on the Bible, okay? So, sir, do you mind holding this for me 1 second? Sorry, thank you. So, I've got this Quran.
Yes.
Do you read Arabic?
I can read Arabic.
Do you understand Arabic?
I can understand what I learn.
Okay. Like, are you Arabic speaker?
I'm not Arabic speaker.
Okay. So you read it and you understand it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Translation we understand.
That's fine. So, here's an Arabic Quran. Can you just tell me what it says?
Yeah, Al-Quran Al-Kareem.
And what else it says? It says something else.
Yeah, what does it say something else? Probably the company who made it. Okay.
No, just read it. Don't make it up. I'm trying to have proper conversation.
For me, reading Al-Quran Al-Kareem, that's
okay.
Enough. Okay?
So, what is these writings?
Okay, you tell me what is it.
It tells about this is the reading of the Khalid. Okay?
This is reading now?
Khalid.
Khalid.
Okay?
Khalid ibn al-Walid.
Khalid ibn al-Walid?
Layth bin Khalid.
Who?
Layth bin Khalid. Okay?
Who
so, let me just. So, this is the Quran.
Yes.
I didn't get it from the masjid, but I bought it. Okay?
Okay, no problem.
This Quran.
Yes.
Is different from this Quran.
How?
You told me.
Okay, get the
I'm gonna give you an example.
Okay, let's check.
I'm
get
gonna give you
surah.
Just a moment. I listened to you well. Now I'm responding your claim.
Yes.
Okay? So you it will be helpful if we respect one another as we speak. So this Quran
yes.
is different from this Quran when you say they are same. in all the mosques in 5,000 in 5,000 different words. Okay.
So
let me just make my.
Yes, Quran has got 114 surahs.
Which one?
Both of them.
This one is Quran, but this one is not.
Arabic. I'm talking about Arabic version.
I read Arabic. This look. This Ma'ani al-Quran, it means...
I'm talking about Arabic.
Sorry, the understanding of Quran. This one, explaining the Quran, but it's not Quran.
Okay,
this
I'm talking Quran. About the Arabic part of the both of the Qurans. So, this Quran is different from this Quran.
That's not Quran.
This is the meaning of the Holy Quran.
Which means tafsir.
Okay, so am I right to think, what I'm going to read it is not part of the Quran?
Show me.
Yeah, let me just open it.
We have got an Arabic speaker here now.
Yeah. So,
so
if you don't see this as a Quran, let me just put them on the floor.
Okay,
it's fine, guys. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. So,
look.
I have the. So, you discredit this as a Quran?
That's not a Quran.
Yeah. So, in this one, the one you are saying
that's
it's not a Quran, let me finish.
By Abdul Yusuf, he explained the Quran by his own opinions.
Okay, let me just finish my sentence.
Quran under my feet there?
Quran doesn't save you. Just let me just focus on something.
Down because
let me focus on.
This has been translated by Yusuf Ali. Thank you. This has been translated by Yusuf Ali.
Okay.
But Arabic is the one people are reciting.
Your point.
So if you are telling me this is not the Quran, can you just tell me why in this one you've got the verse called Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim? Why are you going away?
You put the Quran under my feet there.
I didn't put the Quran under your feet. I put the things on the ground.
Your point.
So in this book, I've got the verse says, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Maliki Yawmiddin Iyyaka Na'budu wa Iyyaka Nasta'in. That's Surah Fatiha in this one.
Okay.
Are you telling me is the Surah Fatiha is not part of the Quran?
It is. It's the first.
But you said this is not the Quran.
I said to you, this is the understanding of Quran. He explains the Quran.
Okay. Even the Arabic.
Verses, of course, it's gonna. Be
even the is the.
Explaining.
Okay. Is this
but
Arabic?
It's not the book of Quran.
Is this Arabic part of the Quran or not?
That's
the Surah
Quran.
Fatiha.
Yeah, that
okay.
One is Quran.
So, and then I guess this is the Quran.
Yes.
Okay. All the Arabics are Quran. Okay.
Okay?
I'm talking about the Arabics now.
Okay. So what's your point? Anyway?
Yeah. The brother who just walked away
made
a claim that Quran is all the same which masjid I go. Do you believe in that Quran?
The Quran is the same, yeah.
Okay. When you say same, what do you mean? Like today every Quran is the same, all the letters?
All the Quran are the same. Since it came, only one Quran. There is no two, three Qurans or five Qurans.
Okay.
Quran is Quran. It's only one book.
Okay.
It's not been edited, it's not been modified, it will never be modified, it will be never be ended.
Okay. What's your name?
Never mind my name. What's your point?
Okay. My name is Hatun. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
So, since you don't have the Quran from the time of Muhammad, since we know ships
Look,
eat the, let me finish.
You
let me
to
finish.
Talk about the two books. And
I am going to talk about the two books. Okay, just be patient.
Yeah.
Since you don't have the time Quran from the time of Muhammad, since we know certain animals came and then eat the certain verses which are not in the Quran, I find it's a bit strange. Muslims are making that claim that Quran is all the same. Beside that, I'm holding two different Qurans in my hand.
Show me.
Yeah, I'm going to show it to you. Can you be helpful and hold this one?
I can hold this one, but I don't want to hold this one.
Any Muslim wants to hold the half Quran? He doesn't want to hold the Quran.
No,
why don't you want to hold this one?
I told you this is not Quran, this is the Quran.
So you don't want to hold the half Quran? In that case, I'll just use my two hands.
Don't do like a snake. Just go straight to the point.
Yeah, I'm gonna do that. No worries. So here is the Surah 4, verse 43. Can you read it for me?
Surah Nisa.
Surah 4 is the Surah Nisa.
Okay.
Verse 43.
Okay.
Can you read it in Arabic for us? Let me just move this.
What is 43? This one.
This one. It starts from here.
No,
it starts from here.
Oh, that's then it's 42. Then
okay, 42.
Yeah. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقربوا الصلاة وأنتم سكارى حتى تعلموا ما تقولون ولا جنبا إلا عابري سبيل حتى تغتسلوا تغتسلوا وإن كنتم مرضى أو على سفر أو جاء أحد منكم من الغائط أو لمستم النساء فلم تجدوا ماء فتيمموا صعيدا طيبا فامسحوا بوجوهكم وأيديكم إن الله كان غفورا رحيما.
Okay. The word which I underline, can you pronounce this verse for with this verse?
لمستم.
لمستم. Okay.
Okay.
What does that mean?
You're gonna show me لمستم.
What does that mean?
You're gonna show me لمستم.
What is the meaning of this word?
You have to know something. The Quran came on seven tongues, which mean seven letters. The word you can say لمستم. You can say لمستم. Same like, for example, the first surah, مالك يوم الدين or مالك يوم الدين, and the both of them. You can't say this is a meaning and this is another meaning. All of them in the same meaning, anyway.
So
it seems like you speak Arabic anyway. Okay,
I'm gonna make my point. So, and then can you, since you read the full verse, can
I
you
don't
just?
Don't trust this one. Don't.
So you don't trust the Hafs Quran. Thank you. Can you just read
what's
this verse?
What's Hafs Quran anyway? What's Hafs?
Are you Sunni Muslim?
That one.
Yeah.
Same thing. Lamastum aw lamastum is the same thing. You see, I'm already one step in front of you.
So they are the same thing.
Al Quran as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said.
Sir, I'm asking simple question. Lamastum and lamastum, are they the same thing?
Look. Maliki and Maliki.
I'm not talking same about Malik, they are different.
Lamastum aw lamastum.
Maliki and Maliki is different
look,
thing.
Lamastum. I touched him.
Yeah.
Lamastum. Same thing. Lamastum.
Okay. Lamastum.
No. Meaning.
You understand now.
Let me.
In the language of Arabic language.
Okay.
And we don't say language.
So,
we say lisan.
Okay.
Lamastum.
So if you've got PhD on Arabic,
lamastum.
I am afraid I have to tell you,
understand?
Your PhD in Arabic language, Arabic lisan, is not very helpful.
Who are you?
Because.
Who are you?
Yeah, so I'm gonna make my case. Just give me a minute. So,
have you got a PhD in language?
Can I see your PhD, by the way?
So you cannot. You cannot.
Let's see how credible your PhD is. Okay.
Let's see.
Sir, are you Muslim Christian?
I am Muslim.
You are Muslim. Is English your first language?
No, Arabic is my first language.
Okay.
يعني تفهم العربية.
نعم.
Is English your first language?
لمستم ولا مستم.
نعم.
Okay.
لمستم.
So.
Okay. What's the question?
So, touch. In a sense of handshake, okay? Can you just shake my hand, sir? Can you just shake my hand?
Go on.
That's all right.
Okay.
Do you need to go and wash yourself now from this before your prayer?
For me? That's a different thing. For me, don't speak about me. Don't speak about my belief.
Muslims, when you shake... Thank you. When you shake my hand, How do you need to wash yourself before your prayers?
Before I pray?
You don't even go there.
I'm just making my case.
Go to your point straight away.
I am making my case. If you are patient and if your audience are helpful. So, if you shake my hand before the prayer, how do you clean yourself? Just you do normal wudu.
Okay.
You do normal wudu. Okay? If you have sex with a woman, what do you do before you go to the prayer?
You have to do the ghusl.
So, sexual touch and handshake, touch in handle, are two different things. We just see in one of them, applications are different. One of them, you simply have a wudu. In other one, you simply have a ghusl. Okay? So, lamastun and lamastun, which for you just touch, there are two different things. One of them is sexual sense touch, other one is hand touch.
Where did you find that
lamastum? You can simply...
Where did you find that lamastum is sexual touch?
That's
where... How did you understand that?
Oh, no, don't worry, I don't...
That's wrong what you understand.
Why are you
can I just respond?
Where did you get it from?
Can I just respond?
Yes. Why you explain it that way? Where did you
exactly,
get this
yeah,
understanding?
That's the main thing.
This is really wrong understanding. We can see now that is wrong understanding. Why? Because you've gone from one example to another example which got nothing to do with that.
But because you made a claim that you've got a PhD on Arabic language, Arabic lessons, and you say that there is no difference in the meaning. I am making my case. No, there are differences. That Alif,
listen to
Alif,
you're not listening to what I'm
saying. Alif, change the meaning of it, because one of them is the sexual, one of them is the handling, and applications of them are the different.
Lamastum, like I said, lamastum, this is what lamastum. Lamastum is like this. There is no sexual.
If some,
about it.
If someone,
it is,
yeah.
There is no such a sexual.
It is, sir. Just go and check the
you
dictionary.
Said
it is, and then applications are even
so
different.
So you made your point, yeah. So this is your point. Thank you very much.
And Muslim just walks away when they see implication of one word is different.
No, but so, the meaning you explain it a different way. If you want to,
what is lamastum? Okay. What is lamastum?
Okay. When you touch different feeling, if you have feeling with the woman,
just
you touch it.
Me.
Sorry. If you have feeling with the woman, if you have something, sexual relationship, and you can touch different way. But if you're friendly, would sometimes I speak to the sister, sometimes by accident I say, listen sister, do you understand? So I don't feel anything sexual, I just make my point with touching.
So
it's different.
Yes, they are different. Lamastum and lamastum, one of them is have extra alif, okay? With that, from the just like friendly touch, it is in the context of the sexual touch. And I'm just making a point, they are different, and we know applications are different, because for one of them, you just do simply voodoo, for other one, you have to do
no,
the
no.
ghusl.
If you tension, it comes to the tension.
How do you know?
If you tension that? Sexual touch, you make voodoo, you make ghusl, if you make sexual touch, that's different things. If you
yeah,
to you, so
I know
listen,
they are different things.
Friend, you know,
what's your name?
Mohammed.
Mohammed.
Yeah.
I know they are different things, because that's the case I'm making. One Quran has different, other Quran has different.
No,
so I was going to ask the gentleman who just walked away, second gentleman who walked away, which one do you follow? He didn't even want to touch this book, but majority of Muslims are the following this one.
No. I mean, touching, you know, that's his... His
application,
opinion, that's
so
a, it comes to division. Don't make it all the Muslim.
Right.
No.
We all represent each other.
Yeah, don't.
Okay.
I don't want him to represent me or the
okay.
other.
Okay. Do you follow
you know
this book?
No, I don't follow.
I don't.
What do you mean to follow? When you say follow, you follow the real book, the Quran.
Which one?
This is the meaning.
Okay. Do you follow?
Yeah.
I probably follow that one.
Yeah.
You follow that
I
one?
I think so.
Okay. Let me just tell you what is in that one. Okay. Because that one is disagreeing.
Is that the one from the Saudi family?
Sorry?
Is that the Saudi family?
So, both of them are from the Saudi. This is the one, Saudi ones.
We follow the Saudi one.
Yeah, this is the one, like half Quran. Majority of Muslims follow the half Quran.
Yeah.
The point I was making, first and second gentleman walked away is, while he says there are the Quran is only one, I am holding two different Qurans, and writing is different. Meaning is different, even though your brother says, it doesn't change the meaning. I'm simply saying it does change the meaning, because implications of that are different. With one of them, you don't need a ghusl. With other one, you need a ghusl. So that's all the point I'm trying to make. So that just already debunks that Quran is all, there is only one Quran. That was Surah 433. So, you say you follow this one. That's friendly.
Yeah, you follow the Quran. It doesn't mean that one. Just this Quran. Quran.
To be honest with you,
I mean, it's
so,
not.
Half Quran talks about
half,
this.
You know the meaning half and I was.
I know. I do.
The half of. So I am Moroccan.
Yeah. You follow the
Welsh one.
Yeah.
Exactly. So. The house and the...
And what is in the... Okay. And where are you from originally?
Kashmir.
Pakistan?
Kashmir.
India?
Huh?
Where is Kashmir?
Kashmir is India.
India?
Yeah.
So, sorry. I know there is insensitive Pakistan and India thing. Sorry about that. So, he follows the Hafs Quran. That's why he follows in Pakistan.
Yeah.
You follow the Walsh Quran.
Walsh, yeah.
In your Quran, it's... Hand friendly touch, okay? In his Quran, it is sexual touch in the context of. So even implications of both of you living in England, even implications are different.
No, if I go to him, I will listen to his Quran. You listen when you recite the Quran. Yeah. We recite the same things. Yeah, even the word, the meaning.
No, you don't. You already told me you follow the Wash Quran in Morocco.
Yeah,
he doesn't follow the Wash Quran.
No, I can follow house as well. There's no problem for me.
Okay, if you don't find any problem.
When I'm at school.
Mohammed.
I got to learn Quran. I will learn house.
Okay. Mohammed. So, it's all right to follow which one you want.
Yeah.
But there is a problem. Only the correct one on the Day of Judgment is going to intercede for you. Your Quran or his Quran. It's the way he recites. Or the way you recite.
Only the correct. Both the same.
Let me finish. Yeah. Only the correct recitation. Lamastun recitation is different. Meaning is different. Applications are different. This gentleman has to do ghusl. You don't need to do ghusl.
No, that's your translation.
Sir, Lamastun.
No.
It's not my translation.
No, he is.
Do you want me to phone up my sheikh?
Sure. Yeah. Ask him what is the Lamastun. You give your phone to someone else?
Do you want to ask
brother? Maybe he will express you more.
Yeah.
Maybe you have knowledge more. No problem. Yeah. Whatever you can do.
Yeah, that's fine. So what is the difference between Lamastum and Lamastum? One of them is extra elif. Yeah.
Yeah. It depends the context. One second thing, not have any difference.
Why there is extra elif if they are not different?
Sorry?
If they are not different,
it's a manner of writing like between Warsh, Moroccan Warsh, okay, and the normal Warsh.
Okay, that doesn't answer my question. So, are you confident that there is no difference? Letter Elif doesn't make any difference in that word. I'll show you how it's written.
In the word, Lamastum doesn't make any difference.
Okay.
Because none exists.
Okay, because you asked in this question, you have to ask the meaning of the word first.
Just a moment.
Okay, if you ask the meaning first.
He already told me meaning of the word.
Because in Arabic, Mastum is not exist any word. It means nothing. I know what you want to say.
I want to say
La, that means
La,
no.
Why is extra?
Yeah. And the Alif, okay, is a manner, you know, the writing,
yes,
like Uthmani writing,
yes,
Moroccan,
yes,
writing.
No, that's not the case. I'm sorry, I have to correct you. That's not the case.
Is not the case? You want to correct me about my language? I can correct you about your language?
Sure.
About Turkey?
Sure.
No, I don't know. I can't correct you.
So, Lamastum.
You don't know my language. You don't correct me. You can't correct me.
So,
you know my language?
One of the Lamastum.
You know my language?
One of the Lamastum has extra elif.
You know my language?
That extra elif.
You know my language?
Sir, don't play that game with me.
How you can correct me to that if you don't know my language?
Don't play that game with me.
No, you don't play that game.
What is your... Not again. It's not again, like it's just like they're just taking the speaker's corner.
I know that you are trying to this argument. This itself great tension.
Tell us.
To me, the best way is acknowledge the difference because a Christian is different and Muslims are different. But you cannot come and argue and say you will reach nowhere. You have to acknowledge that differences. Okay. Whatever they believe,
you know,
it is their belief, and whatever
writing,
you believe is right, it works
for example,
you. It's good for you.
Under the cap.
That is the best solution.
This is only manner to write.
You know. You
let me come back to you. Let me just finish this conversation and come back to you. Is that all right?
Alif, he will not change the meaning because we
it does change the meaning. I can. Okay. Let me give you.
You will be exposed again, like a seashell. Yeah. You remember when you did seashell?
Yeah.
You recognize that one?
Yeah. I'll explain that to you.
They will talk to you if you not. If you said is a seashell, sadafa. When is sadaka?
Sir, just a moment. I'm going to comment on that. Do you know about that thing? Okay. Let me just finish with this Lamastum thing. So, there is an extra letter. You check it. You go home and check it.
It's a manner of writing, brother. It's a manner of writing. Like, look. Look. La, I can write it like this. Okay? I can write it like this. It's three manners. I show you how to write la. she bring for you a manner to write in, then she should know is wrong. No, that is not correct, brother. This is not correct. This is the deceiver manner to do that. Okay? I told you, is we have in Arabic, like English. If you see, check in your computer, you see a lot of manner to write in. Can clean it like this. Oh, a big, this, small, this, this, this. That is the same thing. Same thing in Arabic language.
Let me just make my point. You can go home and check it out. I already showed your brother to the verses. One of them has extra alif, and that extra alif changed the meaning.
Not
and
the meaning.
If he's
because
Arab speaker,
a word have a meaning. Mastum have a meaning.
I'm gonna give you some examples.
If there's example.
Yeah, I'm gonna give you some examples, and then you help me out as well, since you are Arabic speaker. I'm going to give you some examples, and then you, that will be again good chance for you to confront with me. Sorry, slow internet. I'm just waiting internet to...
Sister, how long have you been a speaker for?
I'm not a speaker. I'm simple Christian.
Are you married?
That's rather personal question.
He's trying. What is the problem? Not happy? He wants to marry you.
Okay, it's come out. Sorry.
Nearly, because I got my phone there, please.
It's not about the phone, like file is on my phone.
No, I'm telling my phone because recording there, and I'm here, I need to go.
Oh, okay, come back, like it's just supposed to be coming, just give me... I'm just going to give you some examples how Elif changed the meaning. So Elif makes singular to plural, Elif changed the meaning, I'm just...
Is for vocal. He say to you little bit longer la. He didn't say to you because when he want to say what she want to say to you, yeah. That mean is different. No, brother, it's not different. Is that one is only
that
a vocal?
Meaning?
No,
vocally.
Vocal. It's only a vocal. It's just like I'm saying.
I disagree
listen,
on
listen,
that.
Listen, yeah. Let her disagree. I don't care.
Okay. Look, while you, let me just respond to.
And la. Did they make any difference in the what they want to tell you? No difference. Is that? But when they want to say to you, if, when he change, yeah. He will give to you like that one I showed to you with la. That means no. But that one, you only,
okay, yeah.
You only waste your time.
So let me just make my point. I showed you.
Sadafa and
I'll comment on the sadafa. I can comment on that as well.
You're already. You're already. You're
so
your story.
there are two words in two different Quran, one word in two different Qurans, and they are written differently. Their pronunciation is different. The way people recite is differently because of the extra letter called A, Alif. And then that changed the meaning. In one of them is in the sexually touch. Yeah. In other one is just like friendly touch, handshake touch. I don't know what you call that. So implications of that, they are different. That's for Surah 4, verse 34, 43. You saw the two words. That's for you to go and check it out. Even the dictionaries will confirm meanings are different. So that's only I can
really,
say.
Really
so yeah, that's what I say. That's what he says. Your job is to go home and check out if my correction is correct or if it is yours. So I check them all with Arabic speakers, not some Arabic speaker who just passed through, but someone who studied Arabic as well. And those translations are the correct. So if you saw both of us disagreeing with one another, but both of us cannot be true, or both of us can be liar, but we cannot be the truth, because meaning written version is different, pronunciation is different, implications are different. My issue is only the right recitation is going to intercede for you on the day of judgment. So you need to make sure you've got the right recitation. Soon after you make sure you've got the right recitation, then you need to make sure that don't make any more claim that your brother made. You didn't make that. Your two brothers said there is only one perfect Quran. It's all the same which masjid you go. That's just simply not true. And other thing is, like, implications are different, meaning is different. Both of us cannot be correct. You need to go home and check for yourself and then make your own conclusions which one is the correct. So that's all I am saying. I'm saying when people made a claim there is one perfect Quran, that's simply not true.
That's dumb. Listen, I'm going to go get some coffee. Would you like me?